In trade, it comes from Mr. Alan Nuckman, the chief market strategist at Agora Financial. Alan, is this Apple pullback from the highs looking juicy to you?
Delicious. Apple delicious. Let's talk about the market first. The market lost 3% last week. 3%. So I know there was a lot of hand-wringing, and this is, again, another opportunity. I don't want to talk about Apple as the stock. I just want to talk about the strategy in general. You see a stock that made $30 billion in pure profit for the quarter, you know, 10% off its highs coming in today. It makes sense to see if it can hold that support point, that breakout point that it had at 125 back in December. So we're leaning on that level once again. Now, this is not the first time. So we did this November, we did this December, we did this in January. Now we're looking to do this in February once again. It's a great risk-reward play once again.
Okay. So risk, reward, walk me through how you're positioning for the reward, Alan. What strikes are you looking at? How are you structuring it?
All right. Again, it's a stock substitution strategy. So I'm buying an option, an in-the-money option. I'm looking at the 123 call for March 5th. So it's about 30 days, as opposed to going all the way out to the conventional March option that gets really expensive and your expiration break-even gets a little bit skewed, or going with the February option. The February option is only $100 cheaper, so you get an extra 2 weeks of time for $100, which makes sense to me. So let's get into the strike. The strike is about a 70% delta, or a little bit more than that, meaning it's going to act like the stock on the upside, being long from 123. Again, that super support's at 125. We're trading around 132 right now, so it's, you know, we're looking at $9 in the money. That option's trading for about 12, so the expiration break-even is about $3 higher with a month of time. Now, this pullback, if there's a V recovery back to the 145 level, this option will about double. But that 145 level, if there's a V recovery, that targets 160 on the upside. So there's still a lot more upside potential in Apple. But I love it when it pulls back like this because it seems to bounce and continues to make a series of higher lows. And now we're making higher highs after that record peak last week.
Okay. So, Alan, you're using the old classic Nuckman trade here, the 120 strike. And
123.
Okay. And right. I will say, I mean, the sell-off in Apple from last week brings it right in line with the series that we've had of higher lows here. It seems like right. This is basically the place to bounce if it happens.
Profit-taking. People have to take profits at some point. So, you know,
why'd they do it in Apple last week?
Profit-taking pull because they made $30 billion for the quarter. I mean, you know, if that's...
You're not a believer that people got squeezed on GameStop and had to find cash in Apple?
All right, let's get into that. You brought it up. I have no qualms with this. This is just money flow. It just happens to be money coming from different people than the conventional hedge funds and Goldman Sachs and the big money. It's different money. That's all. Money's not made or lost. It just moves. And the big guys are upset that it's not moving to them anymore. It's moving elsewhere.
Okay. Different flows, but the same money. It's money just from elsewhere. Though today it's not the same money. It's silver, which is a different kind of money.
That's different. We have to do a whole segment on commodities.
Okay.
That's a whole different game.
Okay, next time. Thank you, Alan Nuckman. Right. Appreciate it, sir. The Apple trade, the 123 calls, chief market strategist at Agora Financial, buying the dip on AAPL.